When Mr. Hussein Abdina, a mobile money agent, was arraigned for the 14 Riverside Drive attack, it must have come as a shock to people in similar businesses that the nature and size of transactions could put them in danger. Investigators are yet to link the transactions to the terrorist attack that killed 21 people. Mr. Nair attracted the attention of police when he withdrew SH 5.2 million in 13 tranches from a bank in one day. There is no limit to the amount a mobile money agent can transact in a day. According to court papers, the agent who is based in Eastleigh, Nairobi, received SH 9 million from South Africa through 52 M-Pesa accounts he registered between October and December 2018. In October alone, Mr. Nair opened 47 accounts. Detectives also want to know why only two handsets were used in the transactions. Mr. Nair is among seven people arrested on suspicion of funding terrorism. The anti-terrorism police unit wants them detained for 30 days. A magistrate court will Tuesday rule on how long they will remain in custody. Even as police question the suspects, the case points to the bigger question of funding for terrorism. Last year, the National Counter-Terrorism Center said those funding such activities were devising new ways of remitting money after the regulation of hawalas and the fight against piracy and illicit charcoal trade in Somalia gained momentum. Mobile money is seen as one of the new ways of funding terrorists. Counter-terrorism experts say Al-Shabaab is financed domestically and globally. Locally, the group thrives on taxation and the illegal sale of charcoal. Globally, it is funded by other terrorist groups, states, the Somali diaspora, charities, kidnapping and the extortion of local businesses and farmers. The Organized Crime and Corruption Reporting Project estimates that the group, which is responsible for most terrorist attacks in Kenya, earns about SH 700 million from smuggling charcoal to the Middle East every year. Charcoal is a financial lifeline for Al-Shabaab as it fights the UN-backed government in Somalia, ACPRA says. Eritrea, Iran, Saudi Arabia, Syria, Qatar, Yemen and other governments have been accused of financing terrorism, though none admits it. The accusation has caused rifts between Gulf countries, resulting in sanctions and blockades,